Hello and welcome, Gemini. This is your November 2021 general reading. What we will do this month, slightly different format to what we normally do, is we will have a little bit of a more in-depth look. And what we will do is we will separate and highlight numerous areas of your life to get a better idea of what's going on in the month of November. Now, before we do that, remember that the month of November is the 11th month of the year, and that 11 is a master number. So whatever it is that comes up for you here, Gemini, is very likely going to be felt stronger and with more emphasis than it sounds, simply because this is a master number month, 11, and therefore this is also a number where, should the guides tell you that there need to be changes made, you have a really good chance of succeeding in making change, simply because we are having an extra energy, which is the energy of 11, at our disposal. Anyway, so what we're going to do is we're going to have a look at the energy, what is actually the guides, what the guides are actually saying to you this month, what you should be looking at or ought to be looking at. And then we look at emotional and love energy around you and within you before we go to opportunities, where we will be looking at what's coming in for you and maybe career and that kind of stuff, right? So let's get things started. Let's have a look at what the guides actually want from you, is the wrong word, but what they actually really advising you to pay attention to. And you have the buffalo, the jaguar, and the hummingbird. Now, we have three animal guides. The one in the middle is the most important, simply because it is flanked by two others. But we're starting with the incoming energy, because we have an incoming energy, then we have the energy that really should be listened to and looked at, and then the outgoing energy. And here's how this works. You have the buffalo. Right now, what the guides are saying to you is make sure your personal space, the area where you feel most at home, is safe and where you feel uninterrupted is probably the word that I'm looking for, where you feel that you have enough space around you to actually see what's going on with you. I think there's an element of being disrupted by too many things going on and by probably too many people and their demands on you. And that's where the buffalo comes in, who is saying, like, you know, you're in my field, but you better behave. Right? So that's the energy that comes in there. And then you have the jaguar. And the jaguar is telling you the reason why you should make sure you have a bit of personal space this month is because you are very unique and your uniqueness should always show and be appreciated. You should be appreciated for who you are, not for what you do for others, if that makes sense. And so you don't always have to do something just to be appreciated. You should be appreciated just because you exist. So that's the energy. The main energy is for you to also therefore look at yourself, pat yourself on the back and say, like, yeah, I'm doing all right, and maybe I'm even doing more than all right. That's important, because obviously this has to do with maybe your sense of self-worth, which is different to self-esteem, if that makes sense. So you need to allow yourself to really realize how awesome you are, because only then will you believe it when someone else tells you that. Okay? And then the outgoing energy is the hummingbird. And the hummingbird and the kingfisher, for instance, are the birds that tell you no matter how crooked the tree is, and the tree could represent your life, you will manage. You will just be fine. So what they're saying to you, if you take some time out to be good to yourself, right, you will be just fine, which also very likely, to me at least, angelically speaking, it feels like you have to learn this month, or emphasize at least, to say no. And tell people that you have the right for a little bit more time to yourself. Okay? So that's the energy that they're giving me here for November for you. Now we're going into anything to do with your emotions, love, and just generally speaking, what's going on with you, Gemini. And you have the drum, the great spirit, necklace and bumpen. Now, the drum tells you that in order for you to manifest or to be appreciated inside a relationship that you may be already in, the drum means you need to make some noise, you need to shift, you need to raise some vibration, you need to hire some energy before things can actually work. In other words, you need to be the person that needs to be a little louder here to be heard and to literally claim your space. So this is about speaking up in a relationship, and also, again, has to do with the overall energy that we just heard. It's about realizing that unless you appreciate yourself, it will be difficult to manifest anyone who appreciates you just for who you are. Right, so that seems to be a bit of a theme here for Gemini, because you have the Great Spirit in the middle. And the Great Spirit is literally the energy that says to you, you are not alone. You have never been alone in this universe. And somehow you isolate yourself. And it doesn't always work to isolate yourself. Right, so obviously, when you look at your star sign, there's two people, kind of thing. you don't always need someone else, if that makes sense. But also there's a part of you that gets lost quite easily, because you feel, if you don't validate yourself, you feel like, oh, you know, I'm not sure what I'm doing here. That's kind of the energy that I'm getting. And all the guides are saying to you is, if you could just, it's easier said than done, to be fair. If you could just start loving yourself for who you are, rather than hoping that somehow someone sees your value and lets you know that you're valued and that you're cherished, your own self-esteem may not necessarily recognize it. Right? So there is a theme here. Your outgoing energy is necklace and wampum. But basically mean you would do very, very well with a bracelet that sort of hangs here and stops where the sternum is, because the sternum is where rejection sits. And maybe transmuting some stale energy of feeling rejected, feeling deflated by life is important, because that's with regards to love, affection and emotion. There are some energies here where apparently some of the pain that you had to go through hasn't been released. And carrying it with you doesn't aid you, doesn't serve you at all. And so if you had a, let's say, an obsidian or tourmaline, just to... Even a pyrite is a good stone to wear for releasing. In a way, it's grief of some sort. It could be grief over things that just weren't meant to be, a grief over situations that didn't turn out the way you wanted to. Whatever it is not necessarily the most important thing to understand everything that happens to you, Gemini. It's just time to let stuff go, right? That's that. So now let's have a look at any opportunities that may come your way with regards to your professional life, for want of a better word. And you have quite a bit of information here. You have the chipmunk, the lynx, the timber wolf, and the red-tailed hawk. So what they're saying to you is, before you try to manifest change, right, before you do anything, just assess first. These things for what they are. Don't put your spin on it. Don't make it sound better than it is. Don't convince yourself it's great when it's not. Really, really important to really step back a little and assess, where am I? Am I happy? Am I truly happy here? See, the energy that I'm getting for Gemini is really the energy of not doing so well when you are being told what you need to do. Following orders is not, even though you do it well, not necessarily something that Geminis have to do. You could run your own business. You could be your own boss, for want of a better word. And you would probably notice if you also can, if you can control, is the wrong word, or maybe it isn't, I don't know. But if you can control your time, that would make a big difference to your life already. So that's the first thing the guides tell you. Then you have the lynx, which means while you're looking at things for what they really are, find a vantage point. So if you find, whoa, this is where I'm at, rather than being overwhelmed by it, just step back a little. Go like, okay, at least I know where I'm at. At least I really assessed life, and now I know what is the truth of the matter and whether or not changes need to be made. Because you have the timber wolf and the red-tailed hawk left. And what that means is that what the guides are saying to you is, with regards to your future, the only person that can make good choices about it and therefore has to be in control, so they somehow use here, of your own affairs, right? Because that's what the wolf is telling you, right? Be the leader of the pack, even if the pack is one, you, right? Be the leader of the pack, yourself. And then outgoing energy is the red-tailed hawk. Now the hawk uses the upthrust of the air to glide. So what that means for you is, while you're assessing, while you're looking at your work life, for want of a better word, and what can be altered and changed there, go with the flow. Don't be super pushy. It doesn't quite work that way. Just pace yourself right and go with the flow of things, because there is an element here in November for Gemini of exhaustion. And since this is also a master number month by default, if you are already quite affected by fatigue, this can only get worse, which is why the guides are asking you to reflect and look at everything to see if things can be brought energetically forward to a better future, right? That's all we got time for, guys. Thank you so much. See you soon.